I looked out the front windows and I saw for the first time just the Earth horizon. That's what it felt like. It felt like I was on the Starship Enterprise and we just entered orbit.
Yeah, so the first time you're in space, it's you don't know how it's gonna be. Because everyone does feel sick when they first get to space, but how long is it gonna last?
It's a problem when you're up in space when you can't put anything down. And you can't just like lay something on the table because it's just gonna float away.
The thing was most difficult was keeping track of your stuff. Right? Because, you know, we have Velcro over here as you look around, right? It's a poor substitute for gravity, it really is.
We go around the Earth 16 times in a 24-hour period every 90 minutes. Watching 16 sunrises and 16 sunsets, we could look right out a window like this and watch the sun come up and it go from pure black to full brightness with all the rainbow colors on the horizon in a matter of seconds.
Typically, you'll have a wake up at a particular time, start taking turns just, you know, kind of brushing our teeth and using the bathroom.
I take my no-rinse shampoo and squirt it also on the scalp, just a little bit.
This is the bravest man I've ever seen in space. I'd never seen anybody shave quite so fast.
And it seems like as soon as you wake up, you're already behind schedule. So you're scrambling, trying to put your stuff away, get breakfast ready, taking a look at the things that you know you're supposed to go do. And it's just, it's a lot of hustle and bustle. And it could be everything from doing robotics operations, moving things out of the payload bay, or maybe moving around on space station. It could be going over to space station, conducting experiments.
Well, whether it's aboard the space shuttle or the International Space Station, a day in space, there are no two are the same. Sometimes it's a spacewalk, sometimes it's a science experiment, sometimes it's cleaning the toilet. And every day is something new, something different. And if you ever get bored or tired or just need a small break, you just look out the window and you will not be disappointed.
The thing that hits me to this day is the difference between a shuttle mission where you're there short term and you're very busy and your head's down and you think you're enjoying space and you think you're adapting to space, but you really don't know that you haven't until you live there. Because when you live there, I was there for 4.5 months, you adapt to space to a whole nother level.
A sleeping bag is fixed to the wall so that I don't float away.
Take a long range shot right about now. Oh, right in the finger! Swatted 2 for 2.
Come on, I'm in max Q. I sub as the keyboard player sometimes.
I like food, and I like decent food, and so having not so decent food, that was sometimes difficult to take. So when we finally got some sriracha sauce on board, my life was much better.
The toughest part about being in space, at least for me, was just missing my family, being away from home.
My favorite Endeavour moment, I would say, is being on space station, seeing Endeavour come up, and knowing that that's my ride home.
The first time you look out the window at the Earth, you realize, wow, everything's connected.
If only every human on Earth could see Earth from space, it might change the way that we are as a species, the way we act on this planet, the way we get along and don't get along.